I think, again, another growing season that has started with challenges. It has been slow getting things planted, slow getting the work done. But let's go back to when some of the corn first went in. We were actually at a dry point. Corn was planted, pre-emergence herbicides were being applied, and it stayed dry for a while. Then we moved into a very cool, wet period of time, lasting a fair number of days. And the concern from farmers and from our agronomists, consultants that are walking the fields of corn, are that weeds are coming through. So I've applied my pre-emergence herbicide, but I'm still seeing giant ragweed in these treatments. I'm still seeing weeds pop through. And that question that comes up to mind is, is my pre-emergence herbicide doing the job that I expected it to? The site that we're looking at today is our corn weed management trial here at our Rochester location, and it really provides an interesting look at herbicides, how they perform, and maybe in a year like this, more specifically, which ones perform or which ones are working the fastest, which ones are we seeing activity right away. The concern, of course, is, again, dry season to start. We planted into dry conditions, stayed dried, then we moved into cool conditions. We've applied a number of different products, and as we've been rating and evaluating the performance, we can see differences showing up based on the chemistry or the site of action that these herbicides work on. The prominent weeds that we have at this site are giant ragweed, common lamb's quarters, common water hemp. When we're evaluating the herbicide groups, we are looking at group 4. We've got group 14s, 15s, and 27s. That's what we're seeing some differences with. As we evaluated the plots, we saw Verdict here at 16 ounces providing about 80% control when we looked at this a week ago for giant ragweed and our other broadleaf species. This really was our best looking plot, showing that the group 14s were giving us the best early activity compared to some of the other group herbicides. The group we're looking at now are resicore treatments, and we believe that having the group 4 in our resicore, we showed this as the next best, or about 40 to 50% control. Where we have the full rate down here pre, you can see the activity is really kicking into gear on that giant ragweed as it curls and showing those group 4 symptoms. Where we had a half rate, we were more like 40% a week ago as we evaluated this plot. But things have really changed in the past 6 days, and we see that activity increasing on both of the trials, both of the plots. Here we're looking at our Acuron at the full rate at 3 quarts per acre. And again, when we evaluated it a week ago, we thought 22-23% control. And this maybe is getting the most question. Is it going to reach back and take out my weeds? In this past 6 days, we've seen quite a change. And now that Acuron is controlling, we see the bleaching going on from our 27s, slower than what we evaluated with the Resicore, and slower yet than the number 14s with the Verdict. But we can see that it's kicking into gear and killing those weeds. Where we have the half rate down, a bit slower yet. Again, only half the amount of the Acuron, the Acuron Flexi. Not quite as clean as what we have with the full rate, but I think the encouraging is that it takes time. These weeds are being controlled. It is taking some time for that activity to kick in, but within 6 days, we've seen quite a change from what we call a 30 to maybe 40% control, now moving up closer to maybe an 80% control as of today, and that we expect to increase even more to a 90% or plus. At Harness, one of our group 15s that's been applied as a pre-emergence program, although very good on our small seeded, like lamb's quarters, water hemp, and the grasses, very little activity on our giant ragweed. What you need to see is that the giant ragweed is coming through. We probably have between 25% control. And it's very important to realize the 15s control weeds as they're emerging. They work on it below the soil surface. So as weeds come through, you need to be very quick and vigilant in watching how the weeds are growing, what the density is, and of course the size, so that you can get your timing of your post program on before you have major competition with your corn. They're a good setup, good starting program, but it's very important, again, come back, evaluate the weeds. In this case, we've got giant ragweed that's coming through, still very small, but our window of coming back to control this should be next week so that we don't have excessive competition with our corn.